In the last session, we have understood that PX is the acronym for pixel. Similarly, we have few more acronyms which I will be using in our ongoing sessions. That is DPI, DP and SP. First, let me write the full form of all these acronyms. PX for pixel and DPI for, can you guess? Dots per inch. I will be explaining more about this very soon. DP, which has a older acronym with name DIP, both are same, but DIP is obsolete. Nowadays we are not using DIP. In place of DIP, they have given a better acronym name, that is DP or DIP, which is equivalent to density independent pixels. Similarly, we have SP for scale independent pixels. In the last session, we have understood that for width and height properties, we can specify in terms of pixels, that is PX, but we know that it is a bad design. Now we will try to understand why it is bad design, what is the alternative for pixel. Before understanding the solution, let me explain these four acronyms in detail. 1px equal to 1 pixel or 1 dot on the phone. We know that for measuring phone screen size or for measuring resolution, we use pixels. Resolution talks more about screen size, or pixel talks more about screen size. Now let us see what is this DPI. DPI means, for example, let us say this is your phone. Dots per inch means total how many number of dots can be embedded in one square inch. Let us say this is one square inch area on your phone. So this is 1 inch and this is also 1 inch. So total number of dots on this square inch is called as dots per inch. This DPI can also be called as density of your phone. Density means, density talks about picture clarity. Remember, more the number of pixels you are having in one square inch, the better you can represent a picture, because by joining more number of dots or more number of pixels, you can represent a better picture clarity. So don't confuse between resolution and density. I have written same thing here. Resolution talks about phone screen size, but density talks about picture clarity. Remember, don't assume that just because your phone screen size is bigger, your picture clarity will be bigger. That's why nowadays, if you see, you are getting bigger screen size phones for cheaper price only, but the picture clarity is not so good, because those phones are coming with less DPI, less dots per inch. If you want better picture clarity or better DPI, you have to pay higher price. That's why if you observe Sony phones, though Sony phone resolution or phone size is less, still the picture clarity is better, because the reason for this is higher the DPI, better the picture clarity and higher the price. Now, based on DPIs, that is dots per inch, phones are categorized into 6 densities. Let me write here. First category is low density phones that will come with low picture clarity. Here LDPI means low dots per inch, or you can say low density phones, which comes generally with 120 DPI. That means if you take such kind of phones on 1 square inch, square inch means width also 1 inch and height also 1 inch. Tell me total how many number of pixels are there in this 1 square inch? Total number of dots are 120 dots total, not horizontal and vertical. Total number of dots in 1 square inch is 120 dots. Nowadays low density phones are not coming, so this is considered as obsolete. Nowadays Android is no more supporting low density phones. So in fact, in the market also, I am not seeing low density phones nowadays. Second category is medium density phones, which can also be called as MDPI, which comes with 160 dots per inch. That means better the picture clarity compared to LDPI. These categories are fixed by Google. So in case of medium density phones, 1 square inch will contain more number of dots. Total how many number of dots are there? 160 dots. That means in medium density phones, you can present a picture with a better clarity. Similarly, high density phones, which can also be called as HDPI, which comes with 240 dots per inch. Next category is extra high density phones, which can also be called as XHDPI, which comes with 320 dots per inch. Generally, higher the density, higher the price. Most probably, medium density phones comes with probably 3000 to 5000 Indian rupees. Generally, smartphone ranges starts from extra high density phones, that is 320 dots per inch. Generally, the price ranges starts from probably 10,000 Indian rupees. Next category is extra high density phones. The short form for this is XXHDPI. This price range probably starts from around 24,000 Indian rupees or maybe higher, which comes with 480 dots per inch. Anyway, you don't have to buy hard all these numbers. Just keep in mind, generally phones will come with different densities based on the picture clarities, based on the price range, which varies picture clarities, which comes with varying picture clarities. Last density is 3 extra high density phones, that is XXXHDPI. Probably this range is extra high-end smartphones or tablets, which comes with 640 dots per inch. Now, with this basic understanding, let us see how giving pixels for width and height is considered as a bad design. Let us say I have a screen design like this, which contains a linear layout with one button, where width we are specifying in terms of pixels, that is 100 pixels. This is considered as absolute value. Let us see what's the problem if we give in terms of pixels. If we give width or height in terms of pixels. Let us say different people are downloading this application on different screen sizes. Let us say first person has downloaded your application and where the first person's phone width is 200 pixels. Tell me how much size the button will occupy. 100 pixels means half of the screen's width, which looks like this. So this is half. And height is wrap content. There is no problem with wrap content. Now imagine that second person has downloaded your application into another phone where phone width is 400 pixels and phone height is 640 pixels. Now width is 100 pixels. Half of the screen size is 200 pixels. Half of this is 100 pixels. That means your button is going to occupy only this much of space, which says welcome. Now observe slowly. On the small phone, it is occupying 50% of the width, if you observe carefully. Whereas in the bigger phones, it is occupying only 25% of the phone width. Now imagine a worst case scenario where third person has downloaded your application into extra smartphone with width 800 pixels and height 1000 pixels. Probably it is a tablet. In this case, how much space will be occupied by button? Half of 800 is 400 and half of 400 is 200 and half of 200 is 100. So somewhere in the corner button will sit here with welcome. Now it looks like I have purchased a big plasma TV and movie is coming at the corner. So obviously what this person 3 will do, he will uninstall your application and he will give bad ratings for your application. Because person 3 has put 25,000 rupees of Indian currency for his phone, but your application is not using the complete screen area properly. This problem is called as compatibility problem. Let me highlight this problem. This is an important problem which a programmer should solve while creating Android applications. That problem is compatibility problem. So if somebody asks what is the problem if you give PX, the problem with PX is it will not fit correctly. I am not saying it will not run properly. It will run properly on different screen sizes, but if your button is occupying 50% of the space on the smaller phone, even in the middle end phone also it should occupy 50% of the space. Even in the larger phone also it should occupy 50% of the space as a width. But how much it is occupying? Since you are giving PX, the absolute value, it will not increase based on the phone size. The expected behavior is, as the phone size grows, automatically your button size also should grow. But it is not growing because you have given width in terms of pixels, that is absolute value. This problem is called as compatibility problem. I will write the definition or the meaning of compatibility problem. If your application or screen design is not fitting correctly in all different screen sizes properly, then it is called as compatibility problem. It is an important interview question also. Let me mark here, very important interview question. Either interviewer may ask, how will you design your application for phones and tablets? Which means the interviewer is asking, how will you design your application so that your application will fit properly on different screen sizes? Or in other terms, the interviewer may ask you, how will you solve compatibility problems or compatibility issues? The very first guideline that you have to follow, while designing your screen is, never use pixels because it will lead to compatibility problem and your screen design will not fit properly on different screen sizes, especially on the high-end phones and tablets. Now, let us see the solution. Solution is very simple. What is the expected solution? As the phone size grows, automatically the width and height also should adjust and it should grow and shrink automatically based on the phone size. That can be done if programmer uses, in place of PX, DP. DP means density independent pixel. Independent means irrespective of phone screen size, it will automatically increase the width of the button. So correct approach is, you can give 100 DP. As I told you, there is a old name for DP, that is DIP. Don't give DIP, but both are same. Wherever you want to give PX, I strongly recommend to give DP. Now when you give DP, Android will automatically check. In the smaller phones, if it is occupying 50% of the width, automatically in the medium end phone also, it will increase to 50% of the phone width. So the same button will look like this. Remember, this will not happen automatically if you give PX. Similarly, in the extremely high-end phones also, it will occupy 50% of the phone width. So which looks like this. For user, it looks like programmer is maintaining consistency. Whether you open application in the smaller phones or bigger phones, button is occupying 50% of the width. Now, with this, the compatibility problem is solved. And user feels happy because programmer is using screen space efficiently. Now, you may be wondering, how Android will do the calculation so that it will increase width automatically when programmer says DP. Programmer need not do anything, just specify DP in place of PX. Everything will be automatically taken care by Android operating system or Dalvik virtual machine. That is where our application will run. So if you are curious about what is the formula for growth factor, the formula is very simple. The basis for this formula is, in MDPI phones, that is medium density phones, 1 DP is considered as 1 pixel. Do you remember how many dots per inch are there in MDPI phones? MDPI phones has 160 dots per inch. That means if this phone is MDPI phone and in 1 square inch, we know that 160 dots per inch will be there. So in this case, if programmer gives 100 DP, 100 DP will be converted as 100 PX because in MDPI phones, in medium density phones, 1 DP equal to 1 pixel. So if programmer specifies 100 DP, internally it is converted as 100 pixels. But let us say same application is running in extra high definition phones are extra high density phones. We know that extra high density phones will come with 320 dpi. That means in extra high density phones, 1 square inch will contain 320 dots per inch. Now, can you tell me what is 100 dpi equivalent to in extra high density phones? In 160 dpi, 100 dpi equal to 1 pixel. That is 1 dpi equal to 1 pixel. In extra high density phones, 1 dpi equal to 2 pixels. Because this contains 320 dots per inch, this contains 160 dots per inch. That means this is 2 times compared to medium density phones. So in the medium density phones, if 1 dpi equal to 1 pixel, in extra high density phones, 1 dpi equal to 2 pixels. So if programmer has given button width as 100 dpi, when user runs on MDPA phones, it will occupy 100 pixels. When a different user runs on XHDPA phones, automatically this will become double, because here 1 dpi equal to 2 pixels. So automatically its width will be increased by 200 pixels. So here it will be represented as 200 pixels width. Here it will be represented as 100 pixels width. That is how it will grow. Similarly, if I have given a button of width 100 dpi, can you tell me how much width it will occupy in XXXHDPA phones? Obviously, 100 into 4 pixels. It will occupy 400 pixels width. So here you can consider pixel as like absolute value and dpi is something like relative value. Relative value means bigger the screen size, automatically it will grow. When I say absolute value, that value will not grow. So as a screen design guideline, I will be giving lot of important guidelines to design your screen properly so that your application will fit properly on different screen sizes. I'll be giving various guidelines. You can consider this as a first guideline. Don't use PX, use DP. Even the better approach is always first priorities, either give wrap content or match parent. If that is not fitting for your requirement, in case if you want to give PX in place of PX, consider DP for better screen designs. I hope you understood the difference between PX and DP. In the next session, I will be covering about SP also, and the same example I will show in studio.